Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another awesome tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create a concrete block in Revit for wall decoration facade. Anyway, let's follow along together for this tutorial because just a quick tutorial one. And I would like to ask you if you watch from start until finish and you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to hit subscribe because your subscribe and your like and your share is motivate me to do more content about Revit. Make sure hit subscribe and turn off all notification. Okay, let's follow along together. And this is Ben talking from Revit Global Knowledge. This is my name, Ben. Okay, so now here is my preview house that I just simply create one. Don't mind me because this one not a correct one. I just simply correct for create my facade there. But if you want this how, I can put link in description. You can download that, but don't mind that because just simply draw only. So I just close this one first. Okay, so now I want to apply for concrete block here for wall decoration. By create that, I need to go to file here, then go to new here, go to family, finding for English for metric. Then we are using for curtain wall panel. We are using the same method similar for create custom pattern that I have created on my previous tutorial. You can check that. I will put link in description because this one is look similar. I would like to go to my interior first, and this one I want to delete first. Now we need to resize because our concrete block, I think we make it for, let's give it for 400 millimeter, and for this one we just give it for square 200 millimeter. So now let's give a dimension, DI on my keyboard for dimension. Alright guys, so now here is 400 by 400. Let me create another reference plan first. RP on my keyboard for another reference plan. I just simply drag down and draw something like this, then select my reference plan here. Give the dimension is for 200 millimeter. Give a dimension DI on my keyboard. Okay, perfect. So now it's time to create our concrete block. I will make it more concrete block is look better when we apply into our wall. I will make four here. Go to create here, then selecting for extrusion. Use a rectangle one, start something like this one, and use an offset one for 10 millimeter. I think it's enough. Then start here again. Hit a space key on my keyboard for move the bob inside my bob here. Hit escape a couple times. Now I want to draw another first. Create another reference plan because I want to draw a circle one. Just draw four line. Start from the center one, something like this. And here as well. Go to the circle one, start from here, something like this. Okay, then here's this one I need to delete first, and this one I would like to delete also. Just hit a space key on my keyboard for a tab key on my keyboard for select all, and it's time to assign for material here. You can select here for assign material here, create a new material here first, then give a name is for, let's say, for concrete block. Yes, something like this. Then hit okay. Go to my family tie here. Then we need to assign for material for just select the three dot here. Here we didn't have what we want, so I simply create a new material here. Just rename it for, okay, just give it for Y. Go to appearance library here. Appearance library, finding for pen. We just using for this one, for the white color one. And now this one is thin up the thin, but I know with this is will be the white color one. Just hit apply. As you can see, hit okay, hit okay again, apply, then okay again. Alright, so here we just hit finish first. CO on my keyboard for copy, then I start copy from the corner here to another corner here again. Go to edit extrusion because we use the same cell. I would like to delete for the center one first. Use a rectangle again, offset 10 millimeter. Start something like this, hit a spike key. Something like this, draw one, this one going to offset for 5. Start here, like this one. Okay, I think, oh, okay, it's correct one, again. Let's me delete. Okay, we start draw something like this first, then use a pick line, give it for offset for 5 millimeter. Select the center one. Okay, sorry, select the center one, delete. And here we need to trim and extend. TR on my keyboard for trim and extend. Just trim and extend here and here and here, here as well. Okay, I think it's perfect. Just it's finished first. I think this one, the line is overlapping, so I need to delete one first. Yeah, it's overlapping. Okay, good. CO on my keyboard again for copy another one. Start from the bottom corner to another bottom corner. Use the same method before, we just use extrusion for create our concrete block. This one I would like to delete first. This one trim and extend. And there. Start draw something like this, and here as well. Start from the center one, use a pick line 5 millimeter. I would like to delete for the center one first. Okay, so I want to add another rectangle here. Sorry, horizontal here. Yes, offset 5 millimeter. Pick line again. SL on my keyboard for split element. I'm going to split all first. Here we might be sometime might be confusing, but we just use split elements first, then we can trim one by one. Let's see how. Okay, let me trim and extend first. TR, trim and extend. Okay, it's good. This one is perfect also. This guy, okay, good. And this guy, the last guy here. Okay, this one we got some problem, just leave it like this first. And here, oh, here I need to add another one. I just copy from here, because the line here is so messy, that's why sometimes we delete our previous one and our line is not correct, cannot stream one. So I just simply select and delete like this. As you can see, now we're missing for the top one. So I need to add ding bed. Just trim again. Alright guys, so here we need to split element again for the vertical one. And okay, this one I think I split already before. Let me try first. Yes, we've split already. Okay, this one we have one. SL, start here, TR again. Okay, perfect, just hit finish. Copy again for because I want to create another one, something like this. And go to edit extrusion, start for the circle one, start from, okay, I want where is the center one, very hard to see. So I start from here, something like this. Yeah, for reference. Then I start something like this. Okay, something like this, perfect. So I would like to delete first. TR on my keyboard for stream and extend. I'm going to stream and extend one by one. This way we cannot. Just keep it like this first. Okay, I think I need to control C of choose a can. I think I use flat element is better. I'm going to split for every corner for the round one, stream and extend again. Okay, I think now this one is perfect. Yes. Okay, I think it's good, just hit finish first. Go back to my 3D here. Too thick, so I want to change that. By changing that, I just like here all. Change this one to 100 millimeter. Okay, just leave it thickness a bit, 150. And this guy also. Change all to 150. Okay, good. So it's time to load into our project, and here I'm going to load into my project here. Alright, so here is a house that I simply draw one, and I'm going to turn this one to hidden line first. This one I want to save. Go to my level 2 here. It's time to draw our concrete block for wall. WA on my keyboard for wall. Then I just simply draw something like this. And this one also something like this one. And here I want to adjustment for size. Just make it for 16 meter. Yes, and this one just leave it for, I don't know, something like 4 meter, I think. 4 meter is... Okay, just leave it for 2 meter. Move here a bit. Sorry. Okay, this one we just want to delete first because I don't want to make a lot of messy in my project. We just apply here, then here you can do by yourself. I'm going to my 3D here first, take a look. Okay, this one, not this one, this 3D. Here is the curtain glass that I have created one. So I want to change my curtain glass here, become my concrete block. I turn off for shadow for this one. I'm going to drag down here, make it something like, okay, make it something like 2.8 offset from the bottom one. It's 400 millimeter. It apply. Then go to my edit type here. I need to duplicate, rename it, change it for concrete block wall. Change the curtain panel profile here, change that one that we load into one. Which one? Family 3, this one. And here you must be trained here to same as your reference level before that you create your concrete block. It's not like this, will be error mistake. So when you are designing, make sure you need to think ahead how you want to draw your concrete block and what size you will apply into your project for your concrete block wall. It's not like this, you use this method will be messy and cannot generate one, as you can see. And boom, you done your concrete block here. It look quite nice as a parametric here, but you the same this method we got some dark side. I'm going to show you because I don't want to wasting your time to watching this after you try to do your concrete block, but later on will be got some error mistake. Your concrete block here must be matched with the for high and weak here. For this one that I create one is 400 by 400, and whenever you apply into your curtain wall for the sitting there inside, as you can see when I apply here, it must be 400 by 400. If you want to create grid brick wall, I saw some requesting from my previous tutorial from my subscriber. He say brick wall please, but actually this one you just use the same methods, just draw the brick wall profile that then you can apply. But one thing you must remember, because I don't want you to wasting your time to create your design here after that this one got problem, because you must be need to remember the vertical grid and horizontal grids must be same as your profile there. That's why Revit will generate automatically is a correct way. And of course you can draw like curve also, and you can check back link in the description on my previous tutorial for learn how to create pattern in Revit, just same as mentors. Just this one I'm going to turn on for realistic, make it easy for you to take a look. As you can see, it's quite cool for this concrete block. And the okay guys, I think it's pretty much. I want to show you how to create the curtain here, but curtain here just use a split line, easier one. Okay guys, it's pretty much for the tutorial. I hope you got learn something new about Revit, and make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on notification for more about Revit, and take a look on the end card because I got recommendation or watch next video that recommendation for my channel. Thank you guys for watching from start to finish. I see you for another tutorial in Revit. Thank you.